Hello, everyone. I am Yucai Yu. I'm from eBay. I'm an eBay machine learning engineer. Today, I am very excited to be here to share with you how we use Ray at eBay. And I will focus on how Ray helped us to rebuild our AI platform. Here is what we will cover today. First is an overview of eBay AI 2.0. And then I will talk about the problems when developing and deploying model at eBay. And then I will talk about how to solve this problem with Ray at eBay. And the last is a look at our future plan. To start, let me share a short quote from a Morgan Stanley analyst about eBay's AI strategy. They said, "We believe eBay is best positioned to capture upside from Gen AI in 2024 to extend its seller-focused features driving listing velocity and quality." So this quote captures our mission to make AI more effective and so that eBay can help our sellers to list product quickly with better quality. That's why we adopted Ray at eBay, and that is why we are pushing forward with AI 2.0. The rise of generative AI has led to larger and more complex models, which requires more GPU power. You know, GPU is very expensive, and we want the GPU is high utilized. And at eBay, the new AI use cases are growing fast, and our infrastructure need to quickly respond. Below chart is eBay's AI platform architecture, and a quick view, you can see we have four big big component. One is our feature store. It is used for the online feature serving and offline simulation. And the second is our experiment platform to manage the experiment. And then we have training platform for the machine learning training, model training, and the unified inference platform. So the eBay AIP 2.0's goal is to upgrade our training and the inference platform by integrating Ray technology. Okay, and then I want to talk about the overall process, a typical process about the model development and the deployment in eBay. From the left to the right, the first step is training data set preparation. In this stage, our applied researchers will correct, clean, and organize the data based on the specific business requirement. This ensures the data is in high quality and ready for use. The second step is to find best model candidate. In eBay, we have our own model catalog, which is similar to the Hugging Face's model hub, with models like Llama, Mistral, Clip, CV, and more. The data scientists will run small tests on different models and data sets to find the best model candidate for each use cases. After that, the next step is the scale training and fine-tuning. In this stage, the science will run the model with larger data set on multiple GPUs and to test the different hyperparameters. The best model is selected where the accuracy, based on the accuracy and the business requirement. Once the model is finalized, it will be stored at a model repository. And in eBay, the model can be used in two classic scenarios. You can see from here. The first is the batch inference and NRT, we call it near real-time inference pipeline. In this scenario, for example, like the image, we could create the image embeddings for eBay's product images. A batch pipeline may be used to generate embeddings for all existing images. And then a NRT pipeline will be used to generate image embedding for new listed items image in a near real time way. Those embeddings will be stored in a vector DB, so other applications can use those embeddings to find similar products. And another scenario is the online inference pipeline. The models like the large language model and the CV model are used in the real time. They provide instant insight and answers, which are important for quick decisions and improving the user interactions. Okay, this is the overall flow about the model deployment and development. So what's the problem and the inefficient in this flow? The first problem we found is around 50% solution development time is wasted in back and forth porting Python to Java. Because when the applied researchers develop models, they use the Python code. And then the soft engineers need translate this code into the Java for the production. This back and forth takes a lot of time and communication, using up about half of our development time. It is the first inefficient. And the second efficient is about the notebook. eBay's old notebook dev environment has very limited GPUs, and it is not sufficient for the large language model development and debug. This is mainly because of we use a static GPU resource allocation strategy, which I will explain later. And the third point is in about the online inference pipeline. In the real production online pipeline, you don't just code one model. Often, you need to code multiple models, or translating this flow and rewriting the pre- and post-processing logic can take weeks. And the fourth part is about the data loading for the training. Basically, it needs a distributed data loader here. It needs support the high throughput data pre-processing. But this kind of logic is complex for the data scientist. And about the batch and NRT inference pipeline, they also have two problems. One is the low GPU utilization. We observed some pipeline even has less than 10% GPU utilization. And also, similar like the notebook, our job is also the static GPU allocation. Actually, no auto-scaling. So it means some GPUs remain unused even when they are idle. Okay? Those are pain points in our model dev and development. So to resolve these problems, and we made a major update to our AI platform by integrating the Ray technology. Now I will walk you through the new design of the AI 2.0, and then I will show how Ray improve in the key scenarios. First is the high level architecture, and from bottom to up. At the bottom is the infrastructure layer, the Kubernetes cluster, which is used to run the Ray job, Ray cluster, Ray serve, and then the data platform, which provides services like the Hadoop and the Kafka for the model training and the data pipeline. Storage platform will provide the storage solution like the NFS and the cluster FS, object store for the model artifact storage and the checkpoint storage, and the monitoring system like the Grafana, Prometheus Alert Manager. Okay, CI/CD provide the AI rebuild automation and the solution build and deploy automation. Okay, it is the base infra layer. Above the infra layer is our AI platform layer. Based on the Ray runtime, we build four products in AI platform. One is the Ray notebook. User can use it for the data processing and model training. And the Ray near real-time pipeline, it used for the near real-time data processing, which we will have example to show details. And the batch pipeline, like the batch inference and the model training pipeline. And real-time serving. Yeah, we build four main products for different scenarios. And then we build a general control plan, the managed service, to for those four products, lifecycle management, ACL control, resource management, and so on. And the top side is the interface, and we have a web portal. User can use this web portal to manage those four products, and also they can run Ray by using the SDK in a Jupyter notebook. Okay, it is a very high level architecture. And then let's talk about how Ray helped us in the key scenarios. Starting from the notebook. Notebooks are widely used for the research and experiment, such as data processing and model training. eBay's old netbook system has some limitation because of the static resource allocation. In the past, as you can see from the left chart, when user starts a notebook, they need to choose how many GPU they need and how many CPU they need, how much the memory. They can specify this information. But once the notebook instance is running, those configuration cannot be adjusted anymore. This configuration is not flex, because we cannot scale up the cluster when needed. And we also cannot release unused resource. So we create a new notebook product based on Ray. The main advantage is user do not have to choose the number of GPU upfront. They just select the GPU and the CPU type, and then we will set up a Ray-powered notebook quickly. So what's the special for this new notebook product. First, this new notebook supports CPU-GPU auto-scaling. As you can see from the left chart, we run both the reshaped and the notebook on a node for control, and then the CPU worker can be added dynamically based on the needed, and they can be released when not in use. So in this way, we can implement the auto-scaling. The user can get more GPUs for training, and when not in use, the resource can be reclaimed. Another important change we did is we standardize the GPU SKU. In the past, when user request a node, they could request one GPU card with a lot of memories. For example, like one V100 and 800 gigabyte memory. But as you may know, in eBay, one GPU node, it can has 8 V100, but only 1 gigabyte memory. If user specify too many memories, the memory will be used. There will be not enough memory for the remaining GPUs. So this kind of user setting could lead to the GPU wasted. To solve this, we standardize the GPU SKU. Especially with fixing the ratio of GPU to memory. With this way, we can solve the GPU fragment and to improve the GPU availability and efficiency. Okay, the second scenario I want to talk about is the batch inference. Here is the left chart. Here is an example of how we create embeddings for all product images at eBay. First, we read all the images from the HDFS and then processing those images, like the cropping and the removing low quality images. And then a CV model will run on these images to generate embeddings, and the embeddings will be stored into VectorDB finally. We identified two main issues in this pipeline. First is the low GPU utilization. As I mentioned before, some pipeline even has less than 10% GPU usage. And we applied several strategies to improve the GPU utilization. The first is we use the read data's stream execution, so the data will flow smoothly between different stages without needing to write to the external storage, which is speeding up the process. And then we use the treatment to do the batch inference, and we find the big batch size will help to improve the GPU utilization. And also, we find a fraction GPU, which is a risk feature, is very helpful because it can run multitasks on a single GPU. So with loads setting up, and we find the overall result was very impressive. As you can see, the GPU usage nearly reached 100% with an average of 96%. The overall throughput is also can reach almost 4 times. Additionally, you can see the code, and the code is quite simple to write. So even the experienced data scientists can manage it on their own. And another example is from eBay's risk team using the raw data reported the raw data based batch inference pipeline helped to increase the GPU usage from 25% to 75% and 2.6 times throughput improvement for their end-to-end use case. So the raw data is quite suitable for our batch inference job. And another problem is also about the batch inference has a problem similar to the notebook. It is also about the fixed GPU allocation. In the batch inference job, it often needs a lot of GPU to work, but because of the fixed GPU, a fixed GPU allocation, the GPU remain unused even when they are idle. So we use a similar approach as with the notebook. We standardize the GPU SKU to resolve the GPU fragment issue and use Ray auto scaling to leverage the idle GPU. And then we applied a preemption strategy based on the Kubernetes. It allows high-level batch inference job to take over low-level notebook jobs when needed. So with this setup to improve the GPU usage in the batch inference scenario. Okay, and another scenario is about our near real-time inference pipeline. This is an example. This example is to predict the user's preference and the style based on the items they browse on the eBay website. Here is how it works. When users look at a product at eBay's website, an event is created and saved in the Kafka. And then we have a long-running read job listens for the events. As soon as the event happens, the system will process it immediately, and it will look at the product, fetch its feature from the item service, and then a model will run on those product features to generate the product style, and then the product style will be stored in our online feature store. After that, another model will run based on all the styles of the product the user has reviewed to generate the user's preferred styles. Okay, this is the scenario about the NRT pipeline. And we find the first problem is a very low development velocity. In the model development stage, the user has to develop the model with the Python to pre and post processing. And then when it's moving to a production NRT pipeline, they need to rewrite those pre and processing logic with Java, or in some system need to use some DSL. This rewrite takes time and may lead mistakes. And then in the model development, need to handle different computing needs. Some tasks need to run on CPU, and some tasks need to run on GPU. It is not easy to split and distribute tasks for a data scientist. And then in the data production pipeline, normally the data process will form a DAG, and to orchestrate the DAG and optimize execution is not easy for the data scientists. So we find the unified Python API can help us solve those problems. First, the REST Python API allowed the data scientist to develop a model and build a pipeline just in Python. This saves time and reduces the mistakes because they don't have to switch between the different languages. And Ray can easily handle both the CPU and the GPU tasks. And we can use the simple text to send tasks to the right resource, making things more efficient, just like the code example I gave. And then Ray make it easy to manage the DAG, and its async model automatically optimize the execution process, and the science or developer no need to consider those engineering tasks. And another problem in the NRT inference is also about the low GPU utilization. From the chart, we see the GPU usage is very low. So what's the bottleneck? And we find the bottleneck is the GPU, because the GPU and the CPU tasks do not match well. For example, in this flow, first it need a CPU to do the image process like the cropping, and then use the GPU for the embedding generation. But when both tasks run on the GPU nodes, the CPU on the GPU nodes actually are limited. Those limited GPU will slow everything down and leaving the GPU underused. So to solve this, we use Ray to move the CPU tasks to remote CPU nodes while keeping the embedding on the GPU nodes. This can improve the GPU usage significantly. Yes, as you can see from this chart, and we see 4 times GPU utilization increasement, and the throughput increased 7 times. So here we use the CPU and GPU task split to improve the GPU utilization. And we're moving the pipeline, the NRT pipeline into the production. We also make 2 important changes. One is the Ray GCS fault tolerance improvement. The GCS manages metadata for the Ray cluster. The Ray team has built the GCS fault tolerance already, but it relies on the Redis. Since eBay don't support Redis, we have to replace it with our internal database system. To solve this, we upgrade the GCS and developed a new storage client. This client will forward the storage commands through the gRPC to an external gRPC server, which can connect any database. Okay, another improvement is about Ray's multi-data center deployment. By default, the Ray can only deploy one data center, and in eBay, we build our federation strategy, a federation infrastructure to help Ray deploy into different several different data centers to improve the HA. Okay, so after all those work, and we see a lot of improvement in our overall flow. First, we saved 50% development time because the unified Python API. And then, with the auto-scaling and the standardization SKU. So in eBay's notebook environment, the researchers can use more GPU resource. And also, with the REST API, they imply the online inference pipeline development. And we improve the GPU usage with the CPU-GPU task split and with the fraction GPU. Okay, so in summary, we think the Ray helped us in three areas when rebuilding the AI platform. One is it improved the developer velocity and time to market because it's the unified API. Save a lot of back and forth code rewrite and orchestration optimization tag. And then the splitting CPU by splitting the CPU and the GPU, we solved the CPU bottleneck to improve the GPU utilization. And the last is the is also with the auto scaling and the standardization of GPU SKU, we improve the GPU availability. Okay, so that's all.